Alright, now let's see how well the sound on this game actually works when we get into it. This is FireWatch. I have no real idea what to expect of this in the slightest. It's like I went into Until Dawn, so hopefully that's good. And jazzed up about this, this could be interesting. Hopefully I don't have to record the start due to audio issues. My microphone's a little harder to tell exactly where I want it on the PC than it is when it's on the console. The console says put my head down and go. Bit of loop-de-loop with some wires, and one wire goes into another and stuff, but on the PC, apparently every game's audio volume's differently. You see, Julia. Learn to click something, or is it just really slow text in case I can't read? Oh, you see Julia. She's about your age, late 20s, laughing with well-dressed professors and grad students from nearby CU Boulder. You, Henry, have I a drink with your pals? Oh, I'm approaching her. Ah, of course. I'm drunk. Why wouldn't I be drunk? You're pretty. You're pretty, she says coolly. You are not, you're a future hangover. What? You reply, confused. Someone should buy you a cheeseburger, she says. She flags down a waiter, and 1 week later, you're Julia's boyfriend. Oh, that moved quick, even though that terrible attitude. Click to use objects. Aha, I got a backpack. It's gone now. A backpack. Oh, well, I can zoom in a wee bit, can't I? Don't tell me this is a bit of a game I need to turn the volume up on. It really would be confusing to me. Yeah, it's never something I have to actually do. Alright, but so it's like this, and if I'm still audible over stuff. Alright. Just jump my backpack into my truck, because I've got the orange truck. Looks quite nice, actually. Whoa! You date for over a year! She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great! You move in, you share an apartment near the school, with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere, really. Life is good. Julia wants to get a dog. Oh, I don't want a dog. With a scruffy, undersized beagle, Julia is in love. She wants to bring you over to class. There is also an intimidating but gentle-eyed German Shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's badass. Well, she wants the beagle. Why wouldn't I get the bucket beagle? Bucket's a good dog. And a week later, you totally forgot about the other one. Julia loves him too. You love him too. 1979. You talk out on the deck. It's summer. 9:30 p.m. and the heat sun radiates off the high desert. What do you think about kids? She asks. Kids? They're not very smart or good at much. I'm saying if you and I have some. A couple of little idiots. That'd be pretty good. In that case, we should probably get married. Yeah, I'd like that, you say. These kids are going to be screwed up enough. It's probably for the best that their parents are hitched. You're absolutely right. Pretty. For a stylized effect, it's kind of pretty. Okay, so where am I going? For a fair trailhead. Don't forget to check in, no fireworks, no recommended food experience like us. You're in their country. Learn to live with bears. I'm going for a walk down a nice trail, am I? Oh. We've fade into black. Oh, 1980. It's a Thursday night and Julia is 4 hours late. She doesn't call. Oh. You're worried and getting angry by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having a fun time. You fight when she gets between the sheets. get mad. Why couldn't you just let me know where you were? You call him an inconsiderate arsehole. Oh, I jumped. She tells you, go fuck yourself. Don't be such a baby. You call her selfish. She knows you mean it and it hurts her feelings. She could have told me she was going out. Julia still likes to draw, 1981. She draws plants from her research. She draws all over the places you go. All over the places you go. All the places you go. She draws you. Ah, I've got her. You know, you're going to pose and flex like you, man. You're going to love her. You look awesome. Yeah, I do. Damn straight. Oh. Damn. This game keeps surprising me. Looks absolutely beautiful, but yet stylized. Two Fox Fire Lookout Tower. 8 more miles still. Oh. Let me just climb over that. Sorry. Oh. 1982. During the summers, you and Julia enjoy walking Bucket at night. There's a festival in town. Brings in folks from faraway places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. Bucket. Bucket gets kicked. Fuck dog. She gets flustered. She has trouble speaking when she's stressed. You confront the attacker. Beat his goddamn face in. Your arm gets cut up, but you beat the guy to a pulp. You don't feel very tough. You cry your eyes out before the cops show up. Julia has to take a different path for that day forward. You say okay. You didn't want to go that way either. From then on, you walk by the river. He hurt my dog. I had to kick his head. 1984. Plans to have kids get waylaid by work. Oh, come on, we've been trying 4 years now. Julia gets offered a job at Yale. Yale's in Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. Great job, associate department chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. Convince her not to take the job. Or agree if she commutes back and forth. She can't commute back and forth. That's not... You just... I don't want to move. You can't take the job. You tell her that this means you two won't have family. She says that's bullshit. She's totally right. Well, no, we won't have a family. She's miles away. She has to take in the job. It means you won't come with her. You say yes. Again, bullshit. I'd go with her if I had to. She decides not to take it. Julius has to leave Boulder on paid leave after having an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she'd happily loaned him to him just 2 days prior. She was found crying on the stairwell. Say that maybe you guys should talk to someone about it. You'd make macaroni and... Oh, we should talk about it. Oh no! After seeing multiple doctors and having many tests, they are worried that Julia might be suffering from early onset dementia. She's 41. Yeah, we can't tell people. Not yet. Oh, Julia. It's in my journal. I like the human picture. Bless. Bucket is getting older. Julia comments that it's kind of nice because he gets in less trouble around the house. A week later, she goes back to the university. 1987, Julie's affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason, unless we burn by the police. She's devastated. She's sent home on permanent medical leave. Some days, you get the Julia who calls you a dope and your unborn children little idiots. Other days, you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes, she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. You tell her family they are crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while, your friends come by with little things to brighten the day. She gets worse. 1988, you spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the 2 weekly visits from Daniel the nurse. He suggests you go somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care, at home. It sits with you for a couple of months. decides to move into a full-time cave facility, or you are determined to kick cave by yourself? Can I still walk the old trail we used to walk then, do I? This is where we used to walk the dog. Just down by the river. Oh, an elk. Hi. Hi, buddy. Ah. It's impossibly hard. The worst is when you get mad at her, that when she tries to cook over food. You can't do anything without her, and she can't do anything without you. When she goes to sleep, you stay up for a few hours drinking on the deck, watching baseball in the summer, college basketball in the winter, drinking then too. You start going out after you pull her to bed. The first time you do it, you worry about her getting up and walking around while you're gone. Put a chair in front of the bedroom door so she can't get out. You go to the same bar at the bottom end of Pill Street. It's nice there. Over time, you tell Sheila the bartender everything. It's a huge weight off. You're home and in bed by 1 a.m. a couple nights a week. You look forward to those nights. I'll give you a break. One night, you stop to the DUI checkpoint. You blow it at 10 and take it to jail for the night. I was going to hide it, but I'm going to tell my sister-in-law, Susan. Julia's parents take the next plane from Australia. They can't believe the state your house is in. They should have come more. They then tell you Julia's going to live with them. You don't argue, you say you'll visit soon. Aww. A few weeks go by. See an ad in the paper for a job. You take it. Into the lookout tower. Oh, so it was going through my life so far then as I head up into the lookout tower for my first day on the job. Oh, we're just reminiscing in general. That's really sad, poor Julia. Turn on the power.
Hello, Two Forks Tower.
Hello, Delilah. How you doing? There we are.
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's hello. Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
No,
it's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine, then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
Oh, wow, these are all pretty harsh. Fine, I'll take the piss.
Okay, you've killed 3 husbands. You're a black widow and you're just out here until the heat dies down and then you'll kill again.
Ooh, very good. Bravo, Henry.
I think that was obviously the correct
okay,
option.
I sleep now?
Not quite. Now you.
Okay, good night, bye.
Let's see, I don't know anything about you. I say you got fired from your job and have finally decided to write your novel. That's the sort of bullshit reason you'll find a man out in the woods.
Good night.
I'm not talking to Abby. Alright, so I'm basically just on the watch for fire in the woods. That's my job, and holy shit. I am actually writing a book.
Henry. Well, I guess good afternoon. You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
Alright. Is there anything else? Alright.
Hey, sorry, guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, what, 14 hours of sleep? Woo.
Yeah, Jesus, I guess.
Hey, I was tired.
6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it. That hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the
job.
There's
got a pine
thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
I've got a pine cone. I've got a pine cone. What am I looking for? Look at a ram thing. What ram thing are you talking about in particular?
It's right in the middle of your room.
You mean the map?
Okay, yeah, I see it.
I see you mean the map.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Firefinder.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
I think I use this to fuck
out your west-facing window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing? Are those fucking fireworks?
Where? Oh, N, to use compass. West-facing window.
I need you to confirm. Do you see them?
I don't see... I see fireworks.
Whoa,
you're right.
That's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set them straight.
I'm really going to tell the kids off about fireworks. Like,
like, kick the shit out of them sort of straight?
No. Jesus, no.
What? I'm not a cop. It's not like I've got a rule book over here.
Just make sure they don't do it again. Take their shit.
All right, fine.
Don't feed anyone a knuckle sandwich.
All right.
You probably need a rope to get down shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
You are kidding me, right?
Secure.
Shut up.
Well, this is kind of funny. I got bleach too. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we can do the bleach. Why can a chymist these things anyway? It's like, I'm gonna pick up random things. The singular mind. Oh. Oh, wow, look at that. That's it, you do a throw. Oh, look, what's this? I'm gonna go at it again. Boom. Boom. Bowl. Yeah. Alright, I take the thermos with me. Quite light to be completely honest. No, alright, I'm chucking on the floor, I'm on a tantrum now. I'm not taking you with me, backpack. Nope. Oh well, no. Automatically taking it, okay. Seems fair enough. Can I go faster? I was going to press shift, but it's obviously not shift. Considering the fact that I'm, you know, bringing this up every time I press shift. Oh god, oh, where am I trying to go? I'm finding the rope in the NFC cache box 306. Where the hell is that? It's a bit hard to see it. There we are. Cash box. 306. And then the two folks look out. So I guess I'm going a different way then. Okay, so I'm going that way. No, I'm 100% sure I'm going the right way. Jonesy Lake. Well, if I went towards Jonesy Lake, I'm going the right way. I'm pretty sure. This is why I don't have a map normally. I'm not the best person with maps. Oh. Then press tab. Okay. Oh, I'm gonna miss having a run button, aren't I? We really should deal with these logs. Can't they move them in his spare time? Sometimes that would be the smart thing to do. It's very quiet, isn't it? It's not, they've got plenty of ambient music and soundtracks, I could have been. Oh, what's this? 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, look at that. I cracked the amazing system. Well, oh, hey man, guy couldn't take it, so I locked up his lookout and put some stuff in the box. Found one of those bars you like, tacking into the park, but let's get fucked when I'm back. There you. Okay. Oh, yeah. Hey, that's got a note. Oh, I probably should have mentioned it to her. Just copy that information down. Map updated. Okay. Old vote, because I'm going to need it. Gotta have the granola bar, alright? I mean...
Hey, there's a snack in here. Probably going to eat it.
Where's that?
I'm at the cash box.
It's like, hey, I'm gonna get the snacks, okay? Cool. Nom. Tasty. Alright, where am I going now? Do you appear for a certain of fireworks? Great, thanks for the amazing directions. I guess I'll just head to wherever I see fireworks. Which I'm assuming is somewhere in the west. So I guess I'll just head in the west. Haha! Press R to toggle jogging. Thank God for that. I hate walking in games. Oh, what happened here?
Hey, there's a tree out here that's been ripped to hell.
And?
Don't you think that's, you know, like, disconcerting?
Henry, there are 500-pound grizzly bears out here. They sharpen their claws on trees.
We don't have grizzlies in Colorado. People killed them a long time ago.
Well, in the thoroughfare, they hunt people, they kill people, they bury their bodies, and then come back weeks later to eat them because they prefer rotten meat. People just disappear.
Don't you think that's disconcerting?
Are you kidding me? I wasn't freaky.
No, Henry, that's life.
Christ, lady.
Holy cow. That's life. Also, where are these fireworks? I'm hearing them. I'm not seeing them. Alright, so... Where am I? I'm missing another one there. I think they're in a medicine wheel? Maybe they're in a medicine wheel. I'll try moving back a bit. I'm not sure anymore.
I take it you fell prey to the Forest Service's big recruiting effort? When it comes to, you know, how the hell you ended up out here?
I saw the job in the paper and figured, you know, what the heck?
Yeah.
What the heck? I've got no ties and no life. Better go spend what's left of it in utter loneliness.
Something like that?
Yeah, thanks to last summer, the bump in Forest Service budget actually allowed for us to advertise for the job. Glad it worked.
Well, that's not good.
What happened last summer that accounted for this, windfall?
Jeez. I mean, the federal government almost let Yellowstone National Park burn to the ground? Ring a bell?
I'm sorry, I was trying to deal with my wife.
Yellowstone is, like, what, 15 miles away? Why would they do that?
Well, the short story is that for 60 years, we got very good at not letting forest fires happen. And then about 15 years ago, they decided that forest fires in wilderness areas like Yellowstone should be left to burn. So that's what they did. I can't believe you didn't hear about this. There were reports that the entire park was gone. Dan Rather telling the country that President Reagan didn't care on the nightly news. I mean, what the hell's he gonna do? Smoke jump in and snuff one out for the Gipper?
So what should they have
done?
I don't even know. By the time the Yellowstone folks realized the little fires weren't gonna burn themselves out, 100,000 acres were gone. It's Yellowstone, you know? People don't want to touch it. But we touch it every single day. But hey, I got a 30 cents an hour raise because we can't have another fiasco.
Wow.
If the goddamn park can burn down again.
I don't know. There's plenty of stuff I can see right now that could easily burn down. I really can't find the fireworks people.
Wow, there's an old, I think it's called a medicine wheel out here.
Yeah, it was made by Crow American Indians hundreds of years ago. Huh? There are lots of small ones. Have you ever been to Medicine Wheel Monument over in the Bighorns?
No, I sure haven't.
Nope,
well, it's worth a 3-hour detour on the way home in August.
Neat. I'll keep it in mind.
Alright, so where the hell's this, where the hell's the firework people? Should I just head to the lake? I've had a bit of the lake, haven't they? It wouldn't take fireworks over to the lake. I'll just make the obvious assumption they're at the lake. Aha.
This shale slide is steep.
Whoa.
How do you expect me to get down this?
I don't remember it being that bad. It's not even named on our topos.
What about shitty boss is gonna get me killed hill?
Oh, is that Absorca Indian? Maybe Creek?
That's actually English for not in my job description. How do you expect me to get down this?
Well, did you get that rope?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, just lash it to something nearby and take it slow.
God damn it. I'm sorry, did I say come up? Boss is gonna get me killed hill. Fine. Oh, and down we go.
No.
Ow. God damn it, I called it the hill the right name. Oh, I still got my wedding band on.
Hey.
What the hell's wrong with you?
My shitty boss almost got me killed.
First, your boss is a delight. Secondly, Jesus. What exactly happened?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
You didn't break anything, did you?
No.
Just make
I'll make
ego.
It.
Well, be careful for Christ's sake.
Tell me to be careful. Oh, for God's sake.
Hey, there's a tie-off point off here, just a little way from the shale slide.
Well, you ready to get back on that horse, huh?
Well, I can't go any further, is what I'm saying.
That heads south down to the creek, but you should be able to get to the lake just by continuing west. Without any, you know, mountaineering.
All right.
It's a long summer. You can explore later.
That seems fair. Alright, I'll put this way then. Big fuss.
It is a hell of a nice camping spot down here by the lake.
I haven't been down there in years, but yeah, Jonesy Lake area is perfect.
Looks pretty nice. Oh, hello.
They left their packs tied up here.
The idiots down at the lake?
Yeah, them. I just found where they're hanging out. Oh, look, they decided to have a campfire, too.
You know, they color-coded the fire danger signs in case people were illiterate. But I guess that doesn't take into account just plain stupid, does it?
No, it doesn't.
I left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
Drunk pyromaniacs. Fucking great.
Oh, shit. Ferret or Irish.
Ooh. Looks good. It's mine. Idiots. I'm only just setting a fire here. I'm just going to stamp it out, really. I'm going to assume they're stamped out enough, just the fact it's giving me options to do it more.
Well, I put out their fire.
Man, I would have named that forest fire something good, too.
Yeah, I can always restart it.
No. I think your first instinct was the right one.
Found the fireworks. They didn't even try to hide them.
Well, confiscate them.
Look at it, it's a mess. Oh, magic missile. Screaming wife. It's pretty good, I like it.
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans, they threw them all over hell.
Are you fucking serious?
Yeah, sure am.
I would like to retract my statement about knuckle sandwiches. Feed away.
God. Got a job here to do. Hello.
Well, they left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people.
Well, yeah.
What if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
I found a bra.
A nudie pyromaniac. Remain professional.
Great, this isn't going to be awkward at all. Hello? Excuse me.
Found them in the lake, naked.
Skinny dipping.
Yeah.
Yep.
A guy over there?
Yeah, I do skinny dipping.
Boy, enjoy dealing with that.
Oh, great. The last is just noticed me, Chelsea. That's gonna be fun.
Stereo!
Whoa, hey, put that down! Seriously, it was expensive!
Fucking cool it with the fireworks!
Please just put it down! We won't light anymore!
Alright, catch!
you asshole!
Light another firework and it won't be your stereo, I wreck!
Exactly.
Oh, fuck you, psycho!
Yeah, fuck you!
Fucking pay for this. You can't just harass girls in the woods.
You can't just come here and be a pain in the backside. I work here. Is that it? I'm just just gonna chuck that in there and just walk off and leave from here.
I might have got a little hot.
What's a little hot?
Some of their personal property took a swim. Well, I can't do anything about it now.
Nope. Thanks for dealing with them, though. Seriously.
No problem.
So if I head back, they've still got all their clothes and stuff then. I guess they're just covering themselves up in their own time. Up there. You can't just come out here and take your clothes off, girls. Well, you can. There's something like fireworks and a fire. Set the entire place burning, won't you? That's not what we need. Firewatch. Officer Envy of the Firewatch Brigade. Look, can you see the hassles I have to do? I've got to climb. Just a complete pain in the backside getting down here to deal with you kids. I've got to walk all the way back to the tower.
I have a bit of a confession to make.
What is it?
Look, I was drunk last night when I welcomed you to the job.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
Well, it was a bit noisy.
Yeah, whatever.
Well, I'll try to make it up to you. Anyway, let me know when you get back to your lookout.
Alright, will do.
Oh, hey, I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Shit,
well, that's
get back
bad,
quick then,
right? Because of the lightning?
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home, and try not to get hit by lightning.
Alright.
I got hit by lightning when I was 9 years old, so I'm safe. It's not gonna strike twice and all that.
Well, there was an old lookout named Roy Sullivan who got hit by lightning 7 times.
I don't like the sound of that.
Yeah, well, if it makes you feel any better, it wasn't what killed him.
What killed him?
Suicide. Would you believe?
He survived that and ended suicide? Okay.
I get the sense that not everything in here is useful.
In the boxes? Why's that?
I don't really know what I'll do with the deer horn.
Yeah.
Firstly, they're called antlers. And secondly, stay out here long enough and you'll get creative.
Yeah, just don't need that. Just put that there. Now the flashlight is not working, really.
Ah.
Oh. Okay, it is.
What's in this cave down here?
In Thunder Canyon?
Thunder Canyon?
Really?
Hey, I didn't name it.
Really?
But in the cave?
Thunder Canyon.
I don't know, rocks? NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous.
So
I say, fuck it. You're a grown man, you can go where you want.
Great. Used to go caving with someone back in Colorado. She loved it. Might be great to explore it sometime this summer.
Well, that could be fun. Obviously, be very careful.
It doesn't seem that dangerous. Whoa, whoa! Ah, no!
Henry!
Seriously, it's completely fine in here.
Damn it!
Hello? This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first.
Makes sense.
Although, Debbie says she lost him like 3 years ago, so maybe its mysteries are locked away for good.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, damn.
Yeah, but maybe you can find another one to get your caving kicks in.
Oh, this one's so close to home and convenient, though.
Aw, sorry, Hank.
Fine, I guess I'll climb out this way. I was just going to look around the cave. I don't want to waste my battery on the torch, not just yet. Hello.
There's some guy out here giving me the creeps.
The creeps?
Yeah, what's he doing here?
Wait, he's looking at you? Is he doing anything else?
I don't think so.
Henry, there's something something someone should have told you about this area.
What is it?
It's outside.
Come on.
The whole thing. And people come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
Fuck you.
Bumping into someone in the middle of nowhere is part of the fun.
Why was it creepy, though? Why didn't you just wave and be like, hi there, or something? I don't know. It's damn all creepy-like. Dark and all. Oh, drop down? That's not helpful to be going further up, is it? That guy jumps out to me and he's like, oh, bugger, I'm just done with this. I've just done enough jump scares until dawn for now. Definitely enough jump scares until dawn. Doing that again right now. Oh, for God's sake. Great, got a job that the job ad said needs to be fit and wants to keep climbing rocks all day every day. By the way, the job ad didn't say that, even if she never tests better. Really? Really, it's gonna say trail closed. No. Oh. Wasn't me.
Damn it.
Well, that trail isn't closed anymore.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I took care of the blocked path. It was backbreaking, but, you know, anything for the service.
Well, thank you.
Anytime.
Play the man that did it on purpose. I love it. What is happening?
You know, I don't think there's any fictional character I hate more than Forrest Burns.
Henry, as an employee of the Forest Service, that is treason.
Yeah, well, he really freaked me out as a kid.
He inspired me to spend the bulk of my 30s keeping the wilderness safe.
A shrink would have a field day with you.
Thanks, Mom.
What kind of name is Forrest Burns, anyway?
Well, that would be a pun, Hank. A glorious pun.
I went to junior high with a guy named Royal Butts.
Royal?
Really?
Butts.
I didn't think anyone had been named Royal since the 1850s.
People get named Royal?
Well, Royal's mom, Flo, was a bit of a trendsetter.
Flo Butts.
Flo Butts? Oh, man, that's even worse.
Yeah, well, it's still better than Forrest Burns. So this generator is all the power I've got out here.
Yep, it doesn't go through much gas, and, well, you don't have much in the way of electronics, so...
Lost a bit then, just, you know.
What about my hairdryer?
Oh, I'm sorry. You might just have to make peace with frizzy locks.
I could never.
No. Frizzy locks.
So it's, just the outhouse then, in terms of going to the bathroom?
You're a man, Henry. You can go wherever you want. Well, number one at least. And, full disclosure, I pee wherever I want as well.
Oh, wow. Full disclosure, at least, I suppose. There's no baseball in here. Keeping this. Might need it later. Hello. Oh, we're not gonna need it later.
What can I do for you?
Well, my typewriter is on the ground, outside of my tower.
You write?
Yeah, look, the wind? No. How the hell
Yeah.
You should get inside.
Fuck me.
I'm gonna hold the ball. It'll do more damage than a typewriter. I think. I think probably one to just catch it. That's what the game catches for. Whoa. I put all my books away. Whoa.
Someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker!
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
Fucking kidding me, right? Fetch my damn typewriter back in. Huh.
Okay, I put in a call.
What can they do about it? Will they catch whoever did it?
This is the Forest Service, Henry. They're not exactly Hawaii 5-0. Do you have any idea who would have done this?
Maybe that guy I saw in the canyon, but I don't know why the fuck he'd want to mess with my stuff.
Well, I'll have the rangers keep an eye out for a man hiking on his own and question him if they find him. I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about some deranged hiker going after lookouts? Great. Okay, in the morning I'm going to call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
I need you to feel safe out here.
Got a lot to do right now, to be honest.
Just point me to the Forest Service weapons cache and I'll feel safer than the Pope in his little car.
Yeah, someone made the choice years ago that leaving people with infinite amounts of alone time and a gun was kind of a bad idea.
Grenades?
I'll see what I can do.
Great. Oh, day two! I'm just cleaning up. Feels like I should.
Wake up!
Hey, it's good to see my whiskers there.
Hey, wake up!
Alright. Start a break. Alright. I was gonna end it right here, but apparently I can't right now.
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either. I don't really know why that would be the case.
Should I be worried?
About what?
We can't get help if we need it.
Oh, you're tough, Hank. You don't seem like the guy who likes to ask for help.
Sure.
What I need you to do, though, is hike out to where the wire runs through your area and report back if it's down. Then I can track down a ranger to get someone on it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Yeah, remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So, you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, bye. Hank.
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
I like Henry. Right. My name. Thanks, Duck. Get my name right. Come on, girl. Ooh. So that was Firewatch. Interesting. Quite liking it, though.